Hi, I'm Molly Palmer. I'm singing Popular by Stephen Schwartz. Popular is a song from Wicked. Wicked is a prequel to The Wizard of Oz. In the scene I am singing, Glinda and Alphaba are at school together. Glinda is trying to help Alphaba become more popular, but Alphaba doesn't really want her help. Something to listen for is Glinda's personality is very bubbly and she gets very excited very easily.
Whenever I see someone less fortunate than I, and let's face it, who isn't less fortunate than I? My tender heart tends to start to bleed. And when someone needs a makeover, I simply have to take over. I know exactly what they need. And even in your case, though it's the toughest case I've yet to face, don't worry, I'm determined to succeed. Follow my lead, and yes, indeed, you will be popular. You're gonna be popular. I'll teach you the proper ploys when you talk to boys, little ways to flirt and flounce. I'll show you what shoes to wear, how to fix your hair, everything that really counts to be popular. You're gonna be popular. You'll hang with the right cohort, so be good at sports, but the slang you've got to know. So let's start, cause you've got an awfully long way to go. Don't be offended by my frank analysis. Think of it as personality dialysis, that I've chosen to become a palacist or an advisor. There's nobody wiser, not when it comes to popular. I know about popular, and with an assist from me to be who you'll be, instead of dreary who you were, are. There's nothing that can stop you from becoming popular. Lar. La, 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 la. We're gonna make you popular. When I see depressing creatures with unprepossessing features, I remind them of their own behalf to think of celebrated heads of state or especially great communicators. Did they have brains or knowledge? Don't make me laugh. They were popular, please. It's all about popular. It's not about aptitude. It's the way you're viewed. So it's very shrewd to be very, very popular like me. And though you protest your disinterest, I know clandestinely you're gonna grin and bear it, your newfound popularity. La, 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 you're popular, just not quite as popular.
And today I'm going to be playing Cardigan by Taylor Swift. The reason why I chose to play this song was because when she first came out with her album Folklore this summer, I absolutely loved the song, and it was the first music video to come out as well. And I loved how in the music video she played the piano in this elegant, like, outdoorsy place, and I wanted to play the piano for the same song as well. And a fun fact about this song is it kind of comes in a trilogy with two other songs from Folklore. They're called Betty and August, and they all kind of weave together to tell this story from different points of view, and it's really cool, and I absolutely love it because Taylor has been known to put hidden messages and clues in her songs, and I love figuring them out. So I hope you like it because I really love this song.
Thank you. Hi, my name is Alex, and I will be playing The Legend of Zelda main theme by Koji Kondo. Koji Kondo is a famous music writer who also composed the Super Mario Brothers. I hope you enjoy it.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious from Mary Poppins. Fun fact, did you know supercalifragilisticexpialidocious also means something wonderful?
Of your world, and my favorite part is how it tells the story.
Okay, here we go. Okay, ready?
Mm-hmm.
1, 2, ready, go.
If you play this piece, you should look out to the bottom of the page because he's snoring.
Mm-hmm. Jacob Palmer, and I'm playing Sora Dance. Throughout this piece, the hand positions change.
And a fun fact about this song is that there are a lot of repeating chord patterns throughout the piece.
Sana and I am playing Someone Like You by Adele. I have liked this song since I was little because of the powerful lyrics. Adele wrote this song when she was 18 and achieved international fame quickly after.
Thank you. Music by Elton John, lyrics by Tim Rice. Elton John is a famous British rock star. One of his most famous songs is Candle in the Wind.
By Taylor Swift. I chose this song because I really like the piece and I'm a big fan of Taylor Swift. This piece is actually about her Watch Hill house, and the owner before her was actually Rebecca Harkness from Harkness Park, and she was one of the wealthiest women in the US. So I hope you like it.
Thank you. My name is Reeve Cunningham, and I'm going to be playing the song Seven by Taylor Swift. This song is in the key of E major, and the lyrics of the song are all about what it means to be an innocent child before you know what it's like to grow up. I hope you enjoy.
Playing the Downtown Abbey theme. A cool thing about this piece is that the left hand sounds like it's in 3-4, while the right sounds like it's in 6-8, which gives a 2-against-3 effect.
Thank you.
And today I'll be performing Frühlingsglaube by Franz Schubert. This translates to faith in spring, and what I think is really showcased throughout this piece is the fresh and bright feel to it, and I think that's really illustrated through not just the lyrics but through the piano accompaniment as well, because of the breezy and flowiness to it. So here you go.
Hello, my name is Jules Capone, and today I'm going to be playing the Fleecy Cloud by F. Mendelssohn. In the song, there are duples against triples, and the triplets start in the left hand, and the duples start in the right hand, and they switch back and forth throughout the song. In the middle section of this song, it moves through many keys and then returns back to the main melody. The melody of the song is very chromatic. Hope you enjoy.